I don't know what happened to the training department. They ain't here. Where am I?
Would you like me to do the bar talk?
Oh, sure.
All right.
Unbelievable. This kind of... It's made me very annoyed. If you put enough tests on a dog, you'll find something wrong with them. You know,
bet,
it's the
yeah.
same with people, too. Let me test for 75 more things and we'll find something to call it a problem. I assume Pam has supper?
We got the eggplant parm.
Oh, right.
So we have that, and I made some noodles to go with it.
Oh, good.
With
okay.
something different. Instead of spaghetti.
Oh, the sound's on already.
We gotta get more of that fish away.
More of the what?
Fish.
The Saturday fish.
Oh, yeah.
I.
Actually, this batch, I think you ate almost all of it.
Well, no, Matt said it. He didn't take any because he didn't think he deserves it. Matt deserves it.
Oh, yeah. Why did I...
All that he wants.
I'll let him know. I'll
give him a couple
just
meals.
Come up and get it.
Yeah.
Well, hello everyone. Today is Tuesday, the 23rd. Today was a nice break from the heat. It did rain for most of the day or half the day, but I didn't mind it as long as it wasn't 100 degrees. I think the dogs liked it too. All of them seemed to not mind playing in the rain for a while. That made me jump. Forgot I had the laptop on, and in the middle of dinner, there was Carlene's voice. I do not train. I am the kennel manager. So my training, every time you interact with a dog, is training. So the training I do is tell them to not jump on people. Stuff like that. Basic spoon feeding.
Basic manners.
Yes, basic manners. So that, I think, went well. Penny can be a little much sometimes when she wants attention. So I spent like 10 minutes like sitting next to her, having her not paw at me, not nudge me. And it took like 10 full minutes before she like calmed down and was like, "Then I'm not spending time with you." But she tries. So I think I talked about the goats last time. They're still pretty cute. The thrill has not worn off yet. So far, I haven't seen them jump the fence, knock on wood.
Nope.
So, it's keeping them in there.
Nope. Oop, got it.
Which is good. Yesterday, Carlene and I spent a lot of time putting tarps up.
And none of them fell down.
Yes, which I'm impressed with. The dogs are trying. Just with the strings, not with the actual tarps.
Well, if we got it tied up and then cut the tails off, it'd probably be all right.
Right.
Tomorrow, let's try and get the other two tarps in there.
Sounds good to me. And then we knew it was supposed to rain, so Carlene gave me her box cutter knife to do holes in. And apparently I didn't put them in the best places. So this morning I walked in and there was a bunch of puddles. So I like went around cutting more holes, let the water out.
You were supposed to cut them.
Yes, I found that out pretty well. But yeah, so I think they worked pretty well. The dogs aren't scared of them, which is good. Sometimes new things they can get scared with. So I think it's a success.
Yeah. So far, so good. We have a few more pipes to put in or something. I don't know.
Yeah. I think the biggest excitement for me today was I didn't find one like super soft poop today. Or
really?
Like soft poop. Yeah. I think it's been a while since we've had like all consistent good poops. Sometimes there's always like one odd duck that like ate something they shouldn't have or whatever. So it was good. I'm happy with that.
Any of them on any medications?
No.
No. Yeah. The only medications are the pet tabs and the Tums.
Yeah.
Those are our normal stuff. Some people are getting echoes. I don't know.
The sound is on. Up at the great, okay.
It's off.
Is it?
Yep, all the way down.
Okay, yep.
So it might be your computers back home. Tomorrow's my birthday.
Really?
I will be here.
Oh,
just a regular day. So that's my excitement for the week.
We have food coming on Thursday.
Nice.
Isn't that nice?
Yes.
We're not totally empty either, are we?
No.
We have some food left?
Yes. We have.
Because we're down in our number of dogs we have at the moment. But we're about to have puppies, so
yeah.
I don't think we'll change the.
Right.
Order,
yeah.
So.
We have one stack of the adult left.
That's okay.
Yeah, so getting lower, but that would last us a little while. But good. All right. Shayna will be here to help me move it. If it comes after noon, I won't be here.
They're coming after 10 in the morning, which could be afternoon also.
Right. We got the wet food today, which got, we had a bunch of helpers, a group came in, so, but when they got here.
We lucked out, didn't we?
Yeah, I bet when they got here, they weren't expecting to be moving a lot of wet food, but they were very helpful getting it all in. I had said to Donna, who has Wicked, I was like, today's kind of feeling like slow, and then the wet food, I was like, why did I say anything?
That's what happens.
I know, but when there's stuff like that to do, it's helpful.
Oh, yeah.
It's nice.
We got a washing machine.
Yeah.
Yes. We used it.
Did it work fine?
Yes. It was
great.
You can't
put as much in it, of course, as the other
right.
one. But more than the one we had there, right?
Yes. Yeah. That you could put like two blankets and it would take 3 hours to run. We were looking at it like, oh my gosh. But this new one is nice. It tells you how many minutes you have left on it. It's all new and high tech. But yeah, I can't wait to continue using it. And
the dryer is fine.
Yes.
The dryer was newer than that washer was old. That washer was so old. When we got it, we didn't have a dryer, so we hung stuff on all the fences, all the chain link.
Oh my goodness.
Until Janine began to complain that we looked like a third world something or other with all the clotheslines we had hanging up all over the place. We splurged and bought a dryer, and on we've gone. But they are expensive. They are expensive.
Do we have new donkeys? We got two last week. So those are the newest ones. One of them is friendly. The other one kind of wants you to pat it, but won't let you touch it. So it's like, hey, I want attention. And then you go to give it, and he's like, never mind.
Well, a lot of them have been grabbed by the ears.
Yeah, I never go near their ears unless they were born here.
Right.
Are there earliest puppy dates for Gabby and Sizzle? Need to know when to start watching closely.
We're taking temperatures now. The earliest is the 27th for Gabby. 29th for Sizzle, something like that. It was before August.
Yeah.
So start watching now, but in a couple days, watch more intently.
Well, I just felt one in Sizzle, so she got him in there.
Yeah, I felt a couple move in Gabby this morning.
Did you? Oh, good. Well, there we are.
Yep. Donna had said she had never felt a puppy move in a dog belly,
really?
So I was feeling one move in Gabby, and I was like, Donna, put your hand right where mine is. She was like, that's it? I was like, yeah.
Which Donna is this?
Covino.
Okay.
Yeah. Yep. Oh. It is 5:02. I'm going to turn this over to Carly.
Okay. Judy might sit in the car.
Sit in the car?
Yeah, you can
win
the
side. Oh, whatever, yeah. Whatever, I'll talk to you tomorrow.
She might have a sticker on her car. Like pilot type.
Well, I don't know if they have those out there, but I'll make a plan. Well, she'll be in tomorrow. She texted me.
Yeah, so. Okay.
What, do you want this?
That would be my little thing, yep. Yes, indeed. And this is Carlene's whatever in the middle. And then this goes here, right?
And I go over here.
Go over here. And we are down to one because we don't have your metal one. And then you want to tuck that in tight.
But you're doing well.
My metal one is in my room.
Yeah. Using it?
I like it. Okay. The mail is underneath the boxes. And if you see Bud looking for his tool, it's in this drawer. Everybody, please remember. I needed to borrow that from him, and that's where it is. What'd you say? What'd you say, Sizzle? Okay, this is from Ellen Hobson in Pensacola, Florida. And we have, you can have that one.
Thank you.
And she would like 5 chicken bricks. Now I need the envelope back again. Because I didn't put it down. We have a new thing. if we forget to put anybody's in the chicken brick drawer, then they get twice. And we have Harold Wanda with the tough envelopes again. Here we go. Cinnamon yummies. Well, there's the pecan. There has to be one in every envelope. Okay. Jose Perez, Tampa, Florida. The funny sticker on the back. I didn't see that.
He's a regular.
Okay.
Because
yep.
I remember thinking we had a baseball player, I thought.
Oh.
For the Red Sox. Jose Perez or something.
Really?
I thought the name.
Maybe
so,
it is. I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know. Dear Carlene, we'd like to have 5 chicken bricks, please. Best to all, Joe and Eileen. Okay? Well, that goes in there. And then this goes in here. And we have... Jen Gerhold. There we go. Goes in here. The first MTV video was Video Killed the Radio Star by the Buggles? Bugles? I don't know.
Video Killed the Radio Star.
I never totally understood the video stuff anyway.
Well, it was like an explosion of us like being able to see bands on TV.
The only thing I remember about, because I was still in the animal business at that point, was they had this setup. Well, I don't think I've ever told you about the 500 snakes or awful lot of snakes. Black snakes about that big. I had to get a whole bunch of snakes. And the setup they had a kid's birthday table set up with china and glassware and cakes and all that stuff and all over the place. And they wanted to literally drop from not very far, from only a foot or so, these 500 or so snakes onto this table. This is in a studio. And I thought, how the hell am I going to catch all these things?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Because the studio is full of wires
and
everything. And so what we did was we took plastic and put it up underneath the table cloth. Down, and dropped it down out of sight and up, so that when we dropped the snakes, they went off, shooting off the table into this moat sort of situation we had. What a, we got them, but I tell you, that was us. And I thought, what is this stupidity? And I never really had too much regard for MTV after that one. I don't know if I even knew what it was.
Yeah, they exploded.
Oh, dear. Anybody who'd watch that stuff was had to be, at any rate.
It's mostly kids, you know.
I'm sure of it. Well, you can sell anything to kids, you talk about it. And we have Harold and Wanda again with their pecan, more pecan. That's because we didn't get one yesterday. Okay.
All right.
Now. And we have from Sam Keys. We have, I opened it ahead of time. We have Tums, and we have ibuprofen.
She's sending all her stuff for her visit. She brought
her.
This
is for her.
No, I don't know, but she is visiting.
She sent us
the coffee for her visit.
Oh, good. When's she coming?
mid-August. August.
There's a lot of ibuprofen.
I know.
Okay, we got it. Wonderful.
Awesome.
Right.
Thank you.
Well, that'll be fun.
Yeah.
Where, she's from California?
Virginia.
Virginia.
Yep.
I read this funny email. I get an awful lot of emails. And this person was going on and on and on about CA, which I thought was California.
Oh, crazy.
Yeah, about the third.
I'm sorry.
Thank you. Anything else you want to say?
No, I was just
Right. Okay. Took me a while to figure out it was crazy eggs that they were talking about. Pam figured it out. Very good.
No, it takes me a long. It took me a long time too. That's why I was laughing.
Not that time.
Oh wow.
Okay, we have canine Advantix for extra large dogs. We have two of them. 6 months. That is 12 months for 12 dogs. 1 month.
Awesome.
Okay, and this is from Eileen Capps.
Awesome. Thank you, Eileen.
Thank you. It's a good you people all get talking to each other and decide what... I'd hate to have you all decide to send the same thing the same day. But it does get to be spread out very nicely. They're going to give me 25% off if I take my dog in for grooming.
Oh, gosh.
Old day to tell.
What are we going to do to bring in 50 dogs for grooming?
Well, we could do a commercial for somebody with 50 dogs.
Yeah.
50 would be tough, but you'd probably do 30 without too much trouble. Okay, and we have, a puppy pad. This is a brand new puppy pad. It'll fit on there probably the first day.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yep. That's all right.
Yep.
Okay. Got that one.
Thank you. Got it.
We got another flat box. This is from Fugan.
Here we go.
That's from Fugan. Oh. Oh, we got another one. Different shape than the other one. Pretty cute.
Oh, that's a nice one.
That's a puppy pad. Is that okay? Oh, you thought it was food. Not food. Nope. Not food. That was also Fugan.
Right.
And I think the third one was from Fugan also. Put all these in one box. It didn't work out that way. Oh my word. Oh my. Oh. Okay. I know what this is.
Do you write anything else in there?
Go ahead. You got it. This is the laundry basket or something that we put them in. Okay, so somehow we have to figure out how to make this a laundry basket. Oh dear, that went behind the apple cart. How do we do this? It's not edible, dear. You don't want that. You don't want that. It's gotta kind of expand here or something. Can't put an awful lot of laundry in this thing. Sock Monster Laundry Basket. Well, that wasn't right. Aha! It's this way. Is that the way it goes?
I don't know. Seems like it would...
Oh, wait a minute. Here we go. Give us a holler. No, it doesn't say anything about how you do it, so. Must go the other way.
I think so.
Let's go the other way.
There we go.
I think it goes another one. But that's kind of a nice depth right there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a good one.
That's a good one. I think we ought to quit there.
Okay.
Until they're a week old or something.
Mm-hmm.
That cleans up very nicely, too.
I just wipe it out and...
Yep.
We'll put this in here. I'm working on setting up both stations.
Yep.
Just in case.
because with...
Is this yours? Or?
Yeah. With only 3 days apart, it doesn't say who could go first. I don't know who this is from. It doesn't say. Origin is 11733. If that's any help. I don't think that's California. California's in nines or something.
Oh, yeah, yes. Yes, it is.
Oh, boys.
Holy cow.
What on earth? Okay, I'm going to take this and you're going to take the box.
Yep.
You ready?
Yep.
Go. It's very heavy, whatever it is. Huh. All right, let's take it apart.
Oh, yeah.
Are we going to take it apart?
I don't know.
Tiffany, okay. Say 37 Boxford Road here.
No.
It says 16 Chestnut Street in Danvers.
Oh, because here it says ship to 37 Boxford Road.
Huh. Well, I think we ought to try and find out. Let's try and find a phone number for her. Okay. Tiffany Desmond is not a... We don't have a... I don't know that name.
I don't know it either.
I don't see that as a CP.
And these are like... It looks like they...
They look like fabric...
Bolts of...
Fabric samples or something.
Yeah.
Let's keep that all together.
I'll try to find her or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. So where am I? Right. Thank you, everybody. All right.
It's going to have fabric wholesale direct. That's what makes me wonder. I mean, if it was fluffy material, I think it was... Might be awesome, but it's not. Jersey material, but could use that for footing. I don't know. Find out what happened.
Okay.
Okay. Gabby is what, July 28th?
Yeah. And sizzle July.
And 30. We're 5 days.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay. The laundry basket is for the puppies to carry around with the paddings. Okay, put the padding in the basket.
Padding in the basket, okay.
Wrong. I bought one at Costco. I pushed, ah. I will, thank you.
What is that?
They said, can you read the questions below where mail call starts? All three padding.
What is that other one where I bought it at Costco?
The basket.
Oh.
When we were pushing it in and out.
Oh okay.
I want my MTV. Sam, we'll need ibuprofen for all the work I'm going to be doing.
There you go. Okay. Good plan.
If you send your underwear for the visit, hope you mark it personal. They're telling Sam.
That's all right.
What happened to the snakes when the shoot was over?
I gave them back to whoever owned the snakes.
It's amazing that you could find... almost everything, though, right?
Oh, yeah.
Somebody had almost every animal you were looking for?
Oh, yeah.
Around here?
Oh, I had troubles, though.
Oh,
the worst was the praying mantis for the next Karate Kid, because they were filming it at a time of year when the praying mantises were not active in this hemisphere.
Oh, gosh.
I had to get one from Africa.
Really?
From a bug guy. I don't know who, but there is a there's a flight that comes, that went from Africa into Miami on a Wednesday, or I can't remember, but yeah, they flew over one praying mantis.
Crazy.
In a cash flower thing you had up here.
What, oh, corsage.
Corsage box, which was a favorite way of people shipping bugs around. But at any rate, yeah, and then I go out on the job with this crazy thing, and the director wants to film it in the middle of a hayfield.
Oh, boy.
And they always want to film it two or three times or something. And I bought a whole bunch of butterfly nets and fishing nets and all sorts of stuff to try and catch. Everybody on the set had nets to try and catch this thing if it got to flying. But it didn't fly. It just sat there.
Could you imagine?
Oh, my God. In the middle of a hayfield. Oh, it was bad. But I found
it sounds like, yeah.
I had that reputation for, I would arrive on the set with at least the animal I was supposed to have there.
Yeah, I mean...
and then anything could happen. We knew that. Because people change their minds, directors get some other idea, and you know you're not ready for it, then you got to figure out how to do it.
Huh.
It was an interesting go-around.
Used to play the video over and over again.
Yeah, the only animal that I ever hurt was the cockroaches.
Oh,
I set fire to the cockroaches in the parking lot before I brought them home.
Oh, to get rid of them?
Yeah, I didn't want them.
Yeah.
I got them out of some restaurant in Gloucester.
Yeah.
And, but all the mice, all the rats, everything like that, I put them back where I got them.
Yeah.
And some of them were from here.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because I had a rat that had a scar on her back. The shot was in Boston. I remember chasing him through a piece of pipe. That's how you could cover up the pipe on the set, and it would deliver the rat to where they wanted.
Mm-hmm.
So I put in one end and out the other, and we caught it, brought it back, and I put it down the road here, about half a mile down the road. It was back by the next day.
Really?
It was back in the barn.
They say they go back. No, when if you try to get rid of a mouse or a rat, they come right back.
They come back. Well, that one did.
How was your day?
Fine.
You worked on the sorting project.
I worked all day on those holes there.
Looks good, though.
It does look good.
Can I show them?
Sure. Don't argue with it too much.
So, the dishes would fit in there.
Yep.
Looks good.
This is the good side.
Yeah.
We'll paint it white. And I'm going to support it a little bit because I cut an awful lot of wood out of that.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That's why.
Like maybe with a... Would that help it if you had a square trim on the back? Is that what you mean?
Yeah.
I wasn't sure.
Something. Tip it. Oh, gee. Let's tip it so it doesn't hit the top.
There we go. All right. Okay, next. Okay. Wonder if Amazon carries praying mantis now.
Nobody did that. I'll try it. I don't know what time of year it was. It must have been fall because the hay was full up. Not fall, but, you know, sort of Augusty.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Can you talk about the pregnant dog's temperature changes?
Well, the rumor has it that the pregnant female's temperature will drop 24 hours ahead of time. It'll drop to 98 degrees. Their normal temperature is 100, 101. 101 is where they both are now. 100 to 101. The fact that SZA was 99.7, that's damn near 100.
Yeah.
That does not count as the 98 degree drop.
Yeah. Yeah, she was 99.7 and she's 100.4.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm happy to hear my home survived the tornado. Wouldn't that be crazy? Spent 15 years in Oklahoma with all those tornadoes, come back to the Cape and lose your house in a tornado, right? You didn't order fabric to make your own Dogfest t-shirts, did you?
No.
Nope.
Look at chaos moving.
Is she?
Oh, she's, yeah, dreaming. Anybody else?
Is that all? Going once, going twice.
All right. Sold. Thank you, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Good night.